We are the live, and I'm feeling for some action. So I say, go right into it. Okay, so we just cleared episode 38. So we're on episode 39. So we need to get Kai up to level 33 before... Is it before 40 or at the end of 40? Okay, got it. Because we pretty much messed up getting every single other mech. Hey, let's just go. Into it. Episode 39, Operation Planet Gist, part 2. Probably of 2, but we'll see how many parts. He's so upset. Oh boy. This. Assuming they don't have SP. I'm pretty sure there's nothing we're gonna do for this episode. Mech-wise, or unit-wise, I should say.
ちょっと強引じゃない?
Hey, let's go. That's a lot of units we have to use, dang it. Oh, maybe not. Oh, yeah, it is. A lot of stuff going on in this battle, then, it looks like. What did you see? Okay, so what's your source on this? Oh my god. Don't let anybody die, basically, is what you're telling me. A giant flail? I didn't even summon Gilly now, did I? Nigasan! Fight for it,
トロンベ。 私に出会ったことを後悔させてあげる。気にすることもない相手だよ。
Just that thing in particular.
次に期待させてもらうわ。あと一歩だったわね。
仕掛ける。次の行動パターンを予測しちゃったりなんか、調子が。
Out of game, he's here. Okay. Guess he was mandatory for this. I just didn't realize it.
Hyper RV の実力を見るがいい。アンチアレーザー、照射。
Imagine like just a mech with like giant python arms. Holy cow, that'd be terrifying. call it a name. So at some point, I got a couple of videos that are going up. I mean, I gotta transform to my gear first, but I do have a card opening video I need to get to work on, as well as some manga videos I actually need to put up. I'm actually entering the world of manga videos, so that should be interesting. I just gotta get my phone to cooperate long enough for me to transfer the files. I don't think we've seen this thing attack at all this playthrough. Well, we might have. Oh, that's right, yeah, because she got a new suit. That's right. Fairly all right, just doing the giant robot thing. Hope things are pretty well on your end. Hopefully those boogeymans are out there or nothing.
Tanomu wa yo, Lando Grease.
Oh, we haven't seen this yet. Let's watch this. Doing good besides a headache. Been meaning to catch one of the live streams. I've watched YouTube so far. Oh, thanks for that. You don't have to do that. But much appreciated. Hopefully it's not like a severe headache. Hopefully it's something that can go away pretty soon. I've been there. Those headaches are no fun. Especially if it's a migraine. Could be worse, thankfully. What stage are you on? We are currently on episode 39. Finally got to play around with some of the big boy units.
こいつの見た目に騙されたか。
Yeah, that's fine. Alright, let's see how I messed this up. Aren't gonna attack. Music's great. Especially the some of the newer tracks that they introduced in OG2. Like, it's the music is top-notch. Of course, you can't beat like some of the classics, though. We are... Oh, I just realized we're not using Latuna in this battle. There's just so many characters to pick from. It just sucks you can't use them all at once. I mean, that would be totally broken. Best teams in the game. And they keep adding more with each game. Oh my goodness. Yeah, at some point down the road, I'm gonna have to play Gaiden, which, if I'm not mistaken, is the one that takes place after OG2. Yep, that's Gaiden. The Alpha sub-series had so many units that they made a squad system where four units would work together to count as one. Yeah, my buddy Homer, he was actually showing me some gameplay of, I think it might have been Alpha 2. Whichever one that, Sanger was the main character. And, the squad system actually, that's actually pretty rad. That actually seems like a pretty cool system. Sanger. My dude. We need to talk about your accuracy here, buddy. Actually, wouldn't mind trying the Alpha series out of this point. I guess this is like my path into like trying out every single Super Robot Wars game out there. I have a hand playing through the Alpha games now, and yeah, I had to give them some accuracy equipment in the OG games. You know what? I should have done that actually for Sanger. Yeah, I actually need to do that after the battle. You're literally one level away. Oh well, we already have access to one of them. Let's just go all out. Let's just go nutty. The OG games actually take the bulk of its overreach and plot from the Alpha games. Oh, okay. So most of the Alpha, okay, so most of Alpha's plot is reworked. Look into it. I would like to play Gaiden, but if some of the Alpha games have been already translated, I might actually look into that in terms of what Super Robot Wars games do. There's so many video games, it's almost like they just had a 30th year anniversary or something. The Ingram stuff from Alpha 1, Sanger, Adia, Iblis, and Persona were the main characters of Alpha 2. And you're experiencing a lot of that now, and the Alpha 3 stuff has been set up in the latest. Okay. That's pretty cool. Man, I wouldn't even know who to start with in Alpha 2. I mean, I would do all four routes at some point, but I just wouldn't know who to start with. But that's cool to hear that my boy Ingram is in Alpha 1. Or the main dude in Alpha 1. OG Second, the sequel to the Gaiden, has a 100% translation guide story and all online if you want to play that. Okay. That's the PS3 game, right, if I'm not mistaken? Because I actually own a physical copy of that one. Yeah, I remember getting it pretty early on, because it had a character introduced in that OG Second that was actually pretty rad and has a pretty cool rocket theme. It's the guy with the delinquent guy, and I just like the fact that the mech just has a giant jacket. I'm like, okay, this is awesome. It's actually, at least when I imported that game, it actually seems like it was cheaper importing games. Probably got Believe it or not, that mech of his is based off the DGG series, like Sanger's and... Oh, okay. Yeah, that guy's pretty rad. I like him a lot. See, I never really need to get new games. Like, there's this, you know, there's this whole entire franchise that I could just play and be good for, like, a couple years. Who needs Stranger of Paradise? No, I do want Triangle Strategy, though, still. A bit of a... I'm pretty sure they're gonna keep that name as the final game title of that game. I wouldn't be surprised. I wish I could have tried the demo for A Stranger in Paradise. Didn't have my PS5 then. Don't feel too bad. I didn't have a PS5 either. I would have loved to try out the demo. If I do pick A Stranger in Paradise, I'm probably just gonna settle for the PS4 version. Doing a pretty good job. No, they did confirm a little bit later after the demo that it would be coming to PS4 as well. But who knows how well it will run on PS4. Because hopefully it's not like a Cyberpunk 2077 situation where the PS4 version was, from what I understand, really bad. Go ahead and throw a wall on you. Bullet. Triangle Strategy. I really do want to check out the Chocobo racing game. That's going to happen. That should be a lot of fun. I think that's about it. Oh, don't worry about that. Don't feel pressured if you don't want to sub. I actually still need to check out your newest video. I think it might be your newest video where you did the card boxing opening. Actually get a kick out of those kind of videos. Hopefully you got something pretty good out of that unboxing. Please. It was really fun. I wanted to do one more often, and I can't complain about the pool, so I really wanted a Moltres. Yeah, it always sucks when you're trying to get that one specific card, but you can't get it. Like, there's a couple, like, I collect Pokemon cards on the side, too, and, my goal is I would like to have at least one of each type of Pokemon, regardless of rarity, and I've been hunting for a Charizard, and of course it's a Charizard, because that's going to be a little bit hard to pull for. So I got Mankey, so I'm pretty happy. Yeah, some of these moves are pretty rad in this game. Like, man, I would love to use the R Blade. It's just there's just too many good units. Because the R Blade's final move is like pretty sick looking. I don't think we're gonna get the skill point. Though I do plan on doing a second playthrough of this game because I have to see what the other routes are like. And at that point, I'll try to focus more on the skill points. Joined a new Pokemon game. I know people are a little hesitant before it came out, but everybody seems like they're having a good time with the new game, so that's pretty cool. The last two routes of this game are awesome, but so much important stuff happens on each one. It's still only experience one. Yeah. Honestly, that's probably, like, one of my only real gripes about this game. I kind of wish all the routes were just one long story rather than separated like that. Since, like, no matter what, all the routes are canon. Really know if I'll put this over OG1 or not just yet until I actually beat it. I think at the moment, I think this is like slightly better than OG1. Because for one, Tempest ain't here, so I don't have to worry about him in this in OG2. This is my battle. Very nice. At least on the GBA version, it was such a massive upgrade. I loved almost everything about OG2 more. Was a big step up from the handheld games. Yeah, I know my buddy was telling me, somebody, because I'm so unfamiliar with the GBA games, that, they added quite a bit to the, OG2 version of this game. I still wouldn't mind trying out the GBA games at some point. I think that'd be a fun little stream to try them out. And hey, the GBA games at least came out in English too, so I could actually try to find a physical copy of it. Half of the OG1 characters didn't get themes until the PS2 release, like, oh wow, okay. Even Bullet? That's kind of funny. Man, let's keep you on the building. I did use Katina quite a bit in OG1. Sadly, she's kind of been on the back burner in this particular playthrough. Well, actually, what about the Steam play? I mean, it's the theme. Oh, I didn't put her in the guest then. I put her in the giant. What's the name? But yeah, it really is like hard to justify using gas masks, especially in late game. When you have tiger gods and samurais running around, yeah. And then you just have this lone Jess Finn just stuck in between them. Okay, well, you might be able to make this. Later games trying to make the guest mix better with custom loadouts, but even then I had too much cool stuff, especially when they give you the other elemental lords in the same game. Oh wow. I mean, hey, at least they're trying to make them a little bit better, but yeah, like if they're giving you like all the elemental lords in the same game, yeah, you still can't justify it. Unless you want to do a challenge run where you use nothing but gas fans, but, that'd probably be nightmarish. You have gain, don't you know? You can put gain on you, right? That didn't... I have learned that uses Kai's Gant Spin without fail every game though. Wow, really? That's dedication. Cause in OG1, I immediately put, as soon as I could, I put Kai's Kai why am I blanking on his name at the moment? I put him in the mech with the pizza cutter, basically. I'm terrible with names. I think it's the this game. Yeah, I'm actually pretty close to unlocking it. I kind of missed out on a lot of secret mechs in this run, but... I'm aiming for Kai's secret mech. Because if it's anything like, Gillian's guest spin in the last game, it should be pretty good. They are, like, holy cow. I tried to go for it, but I didn't mess it up. I was like, I'll just do it in the second playthrough. It's a pretty sick design. It's pretty good. I'm glad to have it. I love this series that it just goes ham. And I think what I really like about the series in general is it respects its history. Like, it takes even, like, the most goofiest aspects of their past and just, like, works with it. It's not even upgraded yet? Oh my god. Get me all excited now. I know canonically you fought Jetta, but you need to relax my game. Hey. Counter level though too. Oh, we can let Kyosuke handle it. Oh, maybe not. That's why I put it on, you chose it. Oh no, he got it. Nice. Good crit. Hey, we actually got the skill points. Of course. Oh, okay. We just have all the jerks on the battlefield right now. Got it. I had no idea that was Lee's voice. I don't think I've heard him once in this game. Oh my god. You have to hear on Twitter, excuse the quality, it's from 2009. Okay. I understand. The year 2009 was was an interesting time. But yeah, by all means, go ahead and send it to me on Twitter. I got a little worried there for a second. Actually, let me finish this cutscene real quick. He's like, yeah, pretty much. Here's the big boys. Yep, here's the really big boys. they changed Axel's character a lot from the GBA version. He was just an a-hole that just wanted to kill Beowulf and wouldn't listen to reason. Huh. So not too different, but enough that they tweaked it from what I gathered in this game so far. Okay, everybody's just going after the rifles here. Let me make a quick safety save here. Let me check this video out real quick. I prefer Axel like this as a sympathetic antagonist. Yeah, if they definitely give him more character, I'd be up for that, for sure. Alright, let's check this out real quick here. Oh, okay, if you chose her as your main character, go ahead. Oh my god, Kyosuke! That's pretty good. That's really, really good. Everyone has custom quotes with the attack with that attacking guide. Oh, really? Oh, that's gonna be fun. That's really good. That's really powerful. Uh-oh. Oh, good thing I made a safety save. I'm a professional streamer, I promise. Dang it. There we go. Ah, Kyosuke, please. I guarantee there's probably a video out there where everybody does that attack. Like, it's nothing but just that attack with everybody in that gas bin. Alright, let's load this back up. I kind of want that. Oh, you should do that. That would be a really great Twitch alert. Like, somebody raids you and you just hear Kyosuke just scream at the top of his lungs. And that entire reference in Kyosuke's attack refer back to one of the voice actor's roles when he ended up actually destroying the microphone at this point. That's pretty good. There's a certain attack in OG Moondwellers that's similar. Nice. I've heard Moondwellers is pretty good. Let's put Flash on you. Oh, right, you're right. I forgot about that. Moon Dwellers is pretty good. Was the first Super Robot Wars game since OG3 to be in English. Nice. God, that's such a long gap. OG2 is like, and this is GBA OG2 too. We need to get everybody on these buildings soon. Yeah. The only problem with Moon Dweller's is how they handled the English translation. Oh, right. Was Moon Dweller's, like, the first time they did, like, English translation? Yeah, that's right. Yeah. Unless you count the English Frontier games. Nah, we don't count those. I'm definitely looking forward to trying a lot more Super Robot Wars games for sure. If Gaiden's not next, then, I don't know, I kind of want to look at the very first Super Robot Wars game on Game Boy. Actually thought about looking into that. It's nice to play for a sense and to see where the series came from. Yeah. I even had the remake on my PS3. So I think that'd be a pretty cool little sense just to look at the original and then look at the remake on PS3 for just comparison. I gotta stand alone. Because this was an, because when, they first announced that they were shutting down, like, a lot of the PS3 stuff, I got a little, like, not trigger happy, but, I wanted to purchase some specific games online that I probably wouldn't be losing out on, but then Sony changed their mind, thankfully. We might be in a little bit of trouble. They don't have sword breakers? Okay. Also, Wario, hope you've been having a pretty good day today as well. A giant phoenix? if I do lose, I'm probably gonna take the L and not go for the skill point. I'd rather just keep the money so that way I can at least go up the next level. That is a weird thing. I forgot to put her on the fiddle. I like realized that halfway through. I was like, wait a minute, I don't have her out. Also, this thing is pretty sick as well.
あなたに私を止めることができたら 真実を教えてあげてもいいわ。
行くわよ。
オーバーオークスタンライフル。 お利口さんね、 バイスちゃんは。
5%。
Considering
Tugi is Sanger, I think he doesn't need to work out being skilled
though.
This one is probably going to hurt.
Data を取らせてもらう。
It's Sanger's first appearance, Alpha Guide, and he was a pilot at the, however you pronounce that, as an enemy, and the Gate of Magus was his team. Oh, okay. Yeah, I remember that's Sanger's first appearance, as that's what he looks like, which is, that's pretty cool that they brought both versions of Sanger for this game. Again, I love the fact that Bantesco, like, respects his history. There's a reason Sanger is well below. I know he was, like, the most popular male character in the series. Is that still true? Like, I'm sure he's still popular, but I'm curious if he's still the most popular male character. Yes, okay. Fair enough. It's still pretty true. He's my favorite OG character. There's so many good characters. I don't know if I can pick one.
Inga,
信を許すな。
The only male OG that could rival him are Kyosuke, Masaki, and Axel. Okay. I didn't realize Axel was a pretty popular character. I understand Masaki because he's got history. And Kyosuke is pretty cool. I do like Kyosuke quite a bit. Oh, really? Okay. Makes sense. Very nice. That's fine if you want to keep aiming for her. Get out of here, MPW Series 11211. Actually holding her own, surprisingly.
Data Kensou.
Nice try, MPW Series 90210. Well, shoot. And this one. Well, my buddy did say OG2, be prepared to lose a lot of mats. The only thing I'm about, a bit sad about is that we don't get to see all the actual W numbers. Oh, so they actually do exist, like 1 through 10 and all that? That's pretty interesting. Alright, so rest in peace, Erm. Sorry, buddy. You mean another W, a couple of W numbers in the later games. Okay. Yeah, but so far we only met 00, 03, 05, 06, 07, and 10. Okay. Why am I getting, like, Fallout feelings from that?
Data Kensou.
Like, each one is like some bizarre experiment, like the vaults. Alright, you see here, W8, you will be under hypnosis of, I don't know, what's something silly. You'll be experimented upon about having a green thumb. How does that help me with my combat capabilities? Well, when you have a green thumb, you'll understand life around you. You did not answer my question. I have no idea what this ship is for. I'm not risking it. I risked it with Erm. I'm not risking it with you.
Target. Helios Kakarin.
Have weird personality quirks. Yeah, I believe it.
All
right, Okay, so we only lost one unit. If you get the Endless Frontier, you'll know why. Oh boy. This battle's a nasty one that you can do, okay? I mean, they both start with the letter B, granted, but I mean... I'm gonna assume he's just a very confused. Now you're fine, Beowulf. Sort of.
さすがだと言っておこう。ベオウルフ。 行くぞ! 全足の差と同等の力か。 だが!
してもらうぞ。この一撃で決める。ターゲットロック。ピンポイントだよ。別れを言え。貴様を取り巡る。予測精神実行が射程範囲外。 貴様らとは年季が違うわ。
やばい。はい、
ケイト将軍。
浅い。もっと打ち込んでこい。
敵対する者は全て破壊する。
I mean, he put his head on the line, Kai. I think that counts, right? You need to get you off that building. You got persistent.
調整がお前の運命を導く。まずはこちらだ。トロメ、今が駆け抜ける時。受けろ。
あ、ごめん。
打ち抜く。
Oh my God, that was
good. 我を阻むものなし。
Quite a bit of damage.Insert funny joke here. Ash to ash, there you go.Funny enough, talking and laughing with you in the stream has made my headache disappear. Oh, that's good to hear. I'm glad the headache has disappeared. It's like the worst thing too, especially if you like got things to do around the house or something and you just have a headache. You just feel like you just don't want to do nothing. But good to hear that it is mitigated at the very least. No fun allowed. Okay. Never underestimate 1% in any of these SRPGs. I am gonna heal you. Throw a wall. Alright, we're gonna throw a bullseye on you. As one character said, as long as the chances at not zero, the enemy can still have a chance to hit you. Oh yeah, for sure. I remember back in OG1, Urn had like a 1% chance of hitting the... No, he had a 1% chance of dodging. And he dodged it. And I cannot count the number of times I had a 99% chance of hitting an enemy in this Gaia, and I missed. Like, it's so common. Luck is a cruel mistress. You are not wrong. I will say, I think Fire Emblem was probably the game that I had like the worst luck in. I'll never forget being hit at 1% in SRWW. You fail me, move like. Yeah, those 1%, man. And whenever they do happen, it's always the worst case scenario, too. I guarantee it. Just shoot him with a machine gun. Yep, he was force deployed in a frail mech and it got me a game over. Oh, you hate to hear it. He's like, did you really just try to do that? Don't you always hate those times you are deployed in weak mechs? I still think the absolute lowest this series has gotten is OG1. Is for me personally, it's just that first Tempest fight because of that. But of course, to be fair, I didn't really understand the whole mechanics of the game just yet at that point. There's a couple games where a duo and a hero from Gundam Wing has to fight off a group and grunt mechs alone before they get their real Gundams. I mean, I guess that makes sense considering Gundam Wing. Which is actually one of the few Gundam shows I actually watch. I enjoyed my time with Wing.
Okay.
I think I was probably like a lot of people where Gundam Wing was my first introduction to Gundam when it premiered on Toonami. By the way, Heavy Orange is the best man. Wait, what's my first anime period? Oh, wow. That's really interesting. I'd say that's a pretty good anime to be a first anime. My first anime... If we're not counting Speed Racer, shoot, what was the name of it? I remember looking it up too. Never had a chance to finish watching a Gundam show. I remember Wing being pretty longish, if I'm not misremembering. I think a lot of mecha enemies tend to be a little bit longer. They used to be 50 episodes. Oh my god, yeah. That sounds about right. Really want to try to hit them, but you might guess. Nowadays, anime is like 13 episodes. Why is Lee trying to fight? Look. Lee puts the hat a little bit too tight around his head, okay? That is a very big kick that's going to cover up that guy. That's a good flip. Hey, leveled up. Never met a player that likes Lee. I don't like Lee. I can go ahead and say that right now. I'm not a big fan of Lee. I mean, I guess Lee has a cool hat, but other people have that same hat, so... Man could have been a good character if he didn't let his hatred and superiority complex into him, yeah. He's, you gotta have foils in these games, right? I'm gonna let it play out while I'm trying to look for it. Anime. Well, I mean, if we are counting Speed Racer, then Speed Racer was my first anime I've watched. Actually, you can go after her. Was it Gal Force? Is that what I'm thinking of? That actually might have been it. Maybe it was Gal Force. Because I remember, not counting Speed Racer, Sci-Fi Channel, before they changed their name, used to have anime, and they had an anime movie playing. And I think this was like right before Toonami became a thing, if I'm not mistaken. Misremembering. And then, of course, I started, you know, watching Dragon Ball, Sailor Moon, Ronin Warriors, and all the good stuff. Can you hit the battleship, Kai? Can you do that? Okay. Thank you, Kai. You know, Lee would be the type of character that gets hit with a giant sword and just rush over and like, oh, it's fine. You know, our inch is cut in half. It's okay, we're alright. We're all good. Just pretend it didn't happen. I'm Lee, by the way. Good grip. Alright. What enemies do we have on the field here? Is it just the big boy units now? Yeah, it's just the big boy units. You still have flash on.
私から逃げられると思って。今度はこちらの番だ。それがあなたの実力かしら。
I would never get over the combat knife in this game. It is hilarious. Like, the bigger the unit, the more hilarious it holding a knife is. Oh my god, what's the SRX look like with the holding that knife? I gotta look at that later on. Shoutouts to the Bandcaster logo participating in the battle, by the way.
Woo!
戦場で油断するなど。あとは任せて。念じるままに。なかなかの攻撃だ。
Yeah, Mai's pretty cool. She definitely has grown as a character. I wish we got her a little bit sooner, but that's, regardless, she's still a pretty rad character.
What did you say?
Listen. You thought just the ship hovering there would... You know what, Lee? You do you. Oh, I know that ship is still hovering. It got enough energy. You know, don't shoot it down. You know, it's fine. Exactly, yeah.Like, no, we have to wait till 69%. He's like, really? We're gonna risk our lives to make that dumb joke. Yes. We're only 2% away. We have to make this work. Oh my god, that's a big unit. Oh, no, not the knee. Oh my god! Oh no. Yeah, you really don't get a scale, like, scope of scale in the combat. Like, the CGI's cutscenes really emphasize the height difference between the mechs. Got the short again. So much of Ziggs is the battleship. Good God, that's a big boy. All right. Yeah.Bunch of monsters. Thank you. Right, man, you were here the whole time. Yeah. Oh, they're shooting at that one, okay. Time to dip out, gang. Very nice. Oh yeah, sorry about that, buddy. Oh no. Not the captain. He did. See, unlikely he deserved that hat. Went out like bulbs. The feels, man, it's real. Lates. This man literally just said, okay, Lates. What a weird alien. Man. Creature. Oh, look, she even made the comment. Says the guy who wants to cast the Earth in this war, you know, a la MGS. I like Shadow Mirror's enemies. Yeah, they're definitely a good foil, for sure. So considering what kind of game this is. Alright, we are back with Senior Eyebrows. Oh, boy. I love how smoothly they mixed the plots of Kyosuke and Axel here when they were completely... Yeah, they mixed it pretty well. Alright, so that episode took a little bit longer than I thought. So we're going to go through, we're going to train our pilots and whatnot, and then we're going to call it a session. It's been fun. You know what? I think tomorrow, Monday, I'm probably going to strictly do Super Robot Wars. Those are my 2 days off, so I'm able to stream a little bit longer. I think that's what I'm going to do. I think I'm going to concentrate on Super Robot Wars. Alright, thanks for coming out, Wario. Much appreciated. Hope the rest of your day goes pretty well. Yeah, I think that's the plan. I'm going to take the next 2 days and just stream Super World Wars. Just enjoying myself. You have a habitat. 3. My, look at you go. You have attacker and SP regen. Bullet! Let's see. Okay, looks like you're good on him. So we got these guys now. So I don't know if we'll end up using them or not. I desperately wanted to use her so bad, but she... It seems like it's kind of hard to train her. She was good at dodging for me. She was part support for me. Okay. That's probably the way I should have gone with her. I definitely want to try using her in the next go around. Because I really enjoy her character. She's up there for me. Senior? Oh, we gotta save an attacker for you, buddy. She gets better as the games go on. Okay, that's good to hear. Pretty much got you set up to go. So, let's continue the tradition that we're doing right now. I can't believe I've got so many people. I mean, there's just so many people. Boy Russell just sitting on the sidelines right now. Okay. That's pretty much place for our money. Alpha 3 has over 100 units. Oh my god. I'm assuming Alpha 3's probably got the most units in a Super Robot Wars game yet. Probably contribute to the squad system. Oh my god, Gillian! You have no upgrades, my dude. It does. It could have been Z3, but they cut a lot of the secondary mechs. Ah, that sucks. Understandable, but it sucks. I could sell parts, but we'll do that another time. Alright, before I forget, Saint. Thank you. Oh, you can't equip the knife on the SRX. That sucks. Understandable, but it sucks. We're gonna save, and that'll be it. Oh, exactly 2 hours. Nice. Yeah, I want to thank everybody who came out, checked out the stream, even just for a little bit. It was a blast. I had a lot of fun. And thanks to anybody who catches the replays on YouTube later on. Thank you very much. But yeah. So the plan going right now is the next 2 days we're gonna focus on Super Robot Wars. It's my 2 days off, which I tend to stream a little bit longer. So that's been fun. But thanks again, everybody. Shoutouts to Warrior and Bao for being the homies, as some people will say. But yeah, I am gonna go get something to eat because I'm a little peckish. But thanks again, everybody, and I'm looking forward to what we have in store with Super Robot Wars here. Thank you, Kylie. Enjoy the rest of your day as well, Bao. All right, take care, everybody.